Good morning. My name is Dr. Suraj. I've been working in Sharadakshana Homoeopathic Medical College as an assistant professor in Department of Material America. Recently, I had just went to seen a debate show where two persons were arguing for the homeopathy, one homeopath and one non-homeopath, were debating on the scientific aspects of homeopathy. From that, I just came to know that the people who are unaware, basically unaware of the real situation of homeopathy and the scientificity behind that. This is a small hint that I am giving to you, to every one of you, because for the every researcher, so that they can have a research on the things that I am telling. These are some small facts which you can research in, and you can understand homeopathy. Okay, first of all, I will be telling you, I'm just prepared this one on the basis of that debate show where there will be 12 questions are there. They were putting forward 12 point hints which are against homeopathy. Out of that, they were first telling that this is basically a system which has never been reputed by any of the scientific world. They are telling that this homeopathic system is being never accepted by the scientific community throughout the world. For that, I want to tell you something regarding. Basically, in science means Nobel Prize is considered as the one of the highest thing that will be awarded for the great scientists. And Nobel laureates, lots of Nobel laureates are there. And out of that, some Nobel laureates had done works on the homeopathic medicines. This is actually unaware to the many of the peoples in the world. Out of that, I want to tell you about the first person. He is considered as the father of immunology, Mr. Emil Adolf von Behring. He is considered as the father of immunology. He is the person who has... He got the Nobel Prize in Physiology of Medicine in 1901 for the discovery of diphtheria antitoxin. He discovered homeopathic because one of his study has done with the homeopathic ultra dilutions. His study was father of immunology, Emil Behring, asked to suppress his experiment. He discovered that homeopathic medicines enhances immunity. Immunogenic activity. Behring, by his words itself, he wrote, Samuel Hahnemann was right when he took his starting point in the symptoms of the patient. And this is there in his work. If you go through the Adolf von Behring's work regarding the ultra dilutions and the action of medicine, which enhances immunity. Because the ultra dilutions are able to enhance the immunity. That is one of the study done by one of the Nobel laureate, Adolf von Behring. And the next doctor I'm telling is basically Brian David Josephson. He is basically from physics, and he is the person who is had written an article, How Homeopathic Medicines Work, Nanopharmacology at its Best. He's the Nobel laureate in physics in 1973. And next person is basically the one of the most famous Nobel laureate, Luc Montagnier. He has observed, basically, he has discovered AIDS virus, basically. And he basically done the study with the homeopathic medicines, and Luc Montagnier observed that potentized bacteria and DNA virus DNA sequence emits electromagnetic signals at 5C and 6C potencies and forms the specific nanostructures which last for 48 hours and are responsible for the electromagnetic effects measured. And also, Luc Mongner delivered a talk on electromagnetic waves and water properties in UNESCO headquarters, where in that study also homeopathic medicines are used as the ultra dilutions, and the study was conducted regarding the water memory theory and other things. The next Nobel laureate who has just done a work on the homeopathy is basically Erwin Laszlo. He is basically, what he tells is that water has remarkable capacity to register and conserve information, as indicated by, amongst other things, homeopathic remedies that remain effective even when not a single molecule of the original substance remains in the dilution. This is told by Erwin Laszlo. He is basically awarded Nobel laureate for 2 times. These are basically 4 Nobel laureates were telling and explaining about homeopathy, homeopathic dilutions, because every time everyone is having the confusions that in this, when it is being diluted for this much of level, whether it is having action or not. These 4 Nobel laureates in different studies, they had just clearly done with the homeopathic dilutions, which cleanly indicates that homeopathic dilutions are effective as well as it is scientific also. And our science, because we have to, because everyone is in that one of that debate show, they were disclosing that homeopathy never undergone any sort of scientific explanations. Actually, it is the wrong concept. Why? Because every science is basically has to be first based on the observations. Hahnemann was having an observation. From that observation, he has hypothetically, that time why I am telling it as hypothetically, formulate the theories, formulated the method of treatments. Why I am telling it as hypothetically? Because that time the microbes and other disease-causing organisms were not found, not identified. In that instance, Hahnemann has hypothetically told that basically behind everything, there is an invisible organism behind. There is nothing, but it is the bacteria and viruses. This is hypothetically told by Hahnemann in that era itself. And Organ of Medicine is the book which is telling all the varieties of disease. It is basically giving the classifications for each and every type of disease, how it has to be treated. These are cleanly explained in that. And when it is been, because every hypothesis has to be predicted or to be testable or falsifiable. Homeopathy principles are also the, it is testable and can be predicted also. Why I am, because when we are giving a medicine and it has to be the test, has test the production to reproduce, whether it is reproducible. There comes we have to go through the history, how homeopathy has evolved. From the chingona experiment, everyone is just telling about that it is due to the allergic effects of chingona, Hahnemann got that thing. But Hahnemann has proved, introduced 100 drugs to homeopathy. He has a Brewers Union, not only he proved, from his Brewers Union, they had introduced 100 drugs to homeopathy. So it is the first thing they are doing it. Later on, if you go to the next era of homeopathy, that is the Dr. Hering's era, because he is the person who is Dr. Constantine Hering, is considered as one of the father of homeopathic materia medica. He is the person who has worked more on homeopathy after Hahnemann. Why I am telling? Because Dr. Constantine Hering was assigned to demolish homeopathy. He was a real scientist, so he wanted to first test the homeopathy. He tested it. When he tested it, he started to prove it. He repeated all the provings that has done by our master Hahnemann. And he has reproved all the drugs that is proved by him. He and his Brewers Union reproved all the drugs that has been proved by Hahnemann. So it becomes reproducible. And another important thing is that his materia medica is the materia medica which gives the importance of, he has clinically verified these symptoms in patients. and which is noted in the book, which is known as The Guiding Symptoms of Our Materia Medica by Constantine Herring. In that, this is reproved because verified clinical symptoms he has noted with the double thick lines under every drug. The symptoms which are re-verified and re-verified. He has reproved all the drugs. And in totally, he has done work on 400 drugs in homeopathy. So it becomes, when the time passes, it becomes scientifically, it gets proved that homeopathic drug proving is effective and so much of drugs are being read. If it is with, many persons have tried. If you, right now, if you go through the CCRH monographs, right now, according to the modern day methodology, each and every drug is getting proved with controls. Drug proving is done. Drug monographs are being prepared based on the today's principles, today's research methodology. Thousands of papers have been published regarding the effectiveness of homeopathy. They are telling that case control studies are not there. What is case control study basically? Case control study is nothing but it is basically some persons will be kept as it is. And some will be given with medicines, some will be given with a medicine and with some other alternative treatment, and some will not be given. But in homeopathy, we are having very limited number of, and we are not ready to take a risk with the patient. That's why many of the doctors are lacking in case control studies, because clinical control studies. That is the reason why it is. Because many times we cannot take a risk with the patient. Because the thing is that the patient will go away if you are not giving him a cure or a relief for him. So in that manner, if you are making the patient as a control, automatically he will not get relief. As of with the medicine. So it becomes very difficult for a homeopath to do clinical case control studies. But right now, many of the types of studies are also coming. And every time it will be telling us the symptoms. You are treating the symptoms. Yes, we are treating the symptoms. What is a symptom actually? Symptom is nothing but it is the outwardly reflected picture of the internal deranged vital force, what we consider. That means that it is the outwardly reflected picture of the disease which is persisting in. During the Hanumanian era, when the Organon of Medicine and other literatures were written, the older literatures were written, that time, the medicine was not advanced in as of today. So what happens is that they had only hypothetically told. Right now, we are also using all the investigations, all the measures, which is supporting for the identification of disease as well as the symptom. You should know what is a symptom means. Symptom means it has basically four components. The four components are location, sensation, modalities, and associated symptoms, associated complaints. The location means the place or the origin where the symptom comes. Automatically it covers the anatomy, physiology, and the pathological changes that happens over there will be reflected out as the sensation. And that sensation will be having some aggravating or ameliorating features. Some predisposing causes. Etiologic causes. And there may be some other complaints also will be associated with the main one. So with these four components forms a single symptom. And we basically prescribed on the basis of the totality of the symptoms. The totality of symptoms means the sum of all these. All the identifiable symptoms are arranged together. And a picture of the patient is made. Which automatically covers the disease in. And from that, we just come with a similar medicine which is equally corresponding to that. And we prescribe. In this, everything from beginning from the observation, formulation, last prescription, we are totally following the scientific method. Nobody is actually understanding that. Just the doctor is asking them many, many questions. Why they are asking for? It is basically the reflection of that disease. What are the things which is just changes? What are the changes that occurred before and after? Before the infection occurred, after the infection occurred, what are the, which sort of spheres the disease has affected? So homeopathy is basically, he is identifying the symptoms or studying the symptoms means he is studying the total patient. That's why homeopathy is considered as one of the individualistic medicine. If we go through the reports of the FDA, Federal American agencies, they are telling that they are considering homeopathy as one of the complementary medicines only. And they are telling that if you consider five patients, for five patients you will be giving, for the same condition, you will be giving five different medicines. That is what is homeopathy. Why I am telling? Because in homeopathy, basically we treat the patient based on his symptoms. Already I had told you what are the symptoms that we get. And what are the things it will cover also. For example, I will tell you. Four persons are getting fever. Four will be having different presentations. One may be restless. One seeks to take rest more. One will be having some sort of his routines will be different. Some will be having increased thirst. Some will be having reduced thirst. Basically, we homeopathic medicines are having more specific. We identify the medicines more specifically and differentiate with these higher findings. We are having many medicines for fever or many medicines for any disease condition. But how we used to give is that we will be having many drugs. From that many drugs, we will be precisely going for one drug based on the individualistic symptoms. The individualistic symptom means the most identifiable symptoms, which is differentiating this patient from the other ones. That's why we are asking so much of questions in order to differentiate with medicines to identify a single medicine. And another thing is that everyone is telling homeopathy is basically a placebo science. What is basically placebo? There is no matter of placebo science is there. Why I am telling? Because when we are administering the medicines, you just, everyone, please go through the materia medicas. You can, when you go through the materia medicas, you can understand in each and every drug, it is totally filled with the different symptoms of the disease. After reading that, you will not tell that this is not this is a blabbering or a bluffing. And if you read the organ of medicine, in that debate, they were telling organ of medicine as a comic book. They hadn't read the organ of medicine. If you read the organ of medicine, it classifies each and every disease that is existing in this world. It is a total classification of that. It is basically a hypothetical classification which was evolved by Dr. Hahnemann during his period. That time, the microbes or any other medicinal advances were not there. That time, you have to think, bloodletting, leeches were applied. In that time, he was just formulated the system. Today, science has advanced too much. Along with the advancement of the science, homeopathy also has advanced too much. Right now, in India, CCRH, Central Council of Research Homeopathy, is doing many number of researches. Many number of researches, case control trials, drug provings, drug chronographs, everything they are doing. Which is clearly giving a scientific evidence for each and every doctrines. And the homeopathic drug proving right now that is conducted are basically totally ethical and totally done according to the criteria and the guidelines of research. There also homeopathy is getting proved. And if you consider the patients, if you ask the patients and other things, a child who is having below 1 month, he is having a complaint, homeopathic medicines are given. What placebo, whether the child knows that he's been given with a homeopathic medicine, what placebo effect it gets? As of any other medicine, homeopathic medicine is also given to them. The homeopathic medicine works there. And another thing is that homeopathy, because in that debate they were telling that homeopathy is basically some allergic reactions. Can I ask you something? Is every case, every drug, whether it will produce an allergic to everyone? These are all basically some facts to demolish homeopathy. Homeopathy is basically emerging out. And another thing is that in the world, no country has banned homeopathy. That is actually a misnomer. In Australia, it is NMC bill and other things already. Right now, they had corrected it. No one is knowing the correction. Corrected their bill. Because the first one was basically some fault findings were there. So they had corrected and accepted. As of every system, homeopathic system is also having many limitations and scopes also. Every system in the world, whether it is allopathy, homeopathy, Ayurveda, whatever be the system, every system is having importance. And homeopathy is one of the systems. Homeopathy is having scope as well as some limitations also. Many persons are told to support at homeopathy, many persons are against homeopathy. The persons who are against homeopathy are many times they hadn't witnessed the homeopathy. They hadn't tested homeopathy. Before giving a comment regarding homeopathy, please test it first. First, please test it. You read Organ of Medicine fully. And you tell me which is not covered in it regarding the disease or whatever be the medical system. What is not covered? Do you know one thing? I will tell you the first aphorism or the first paragraph which is written by Hahnemann, which determines, which is basically for every homeopath, not only for homeopath, every doctor, this should be a guideline. The physician's high and only mission is to restore the sick to health, to cure as it is termed. This is the first line actually. And he is telling about different classifications of diseases in acute, chronic, surgical diseases. Everything. How, when, where, that guidelines are basically given in the Organ of Medicine. Whenever you get a time, any enthusiastic researcher can just read Organ of Medicine one time, please. Why? Because then, after reading it, test homeopathy. Then after testing it, if you feel that what I tell is wrong, then you can criticize homeopathy. Many persons are not at all testing it. Just by some words, some net findings. In that debate show, that person is telling about basically based on one website where there will be professor Edward Ernest's opinion he is actually explaining. Nothing other he has just done. In that debate, he is just reading that whole his findings he was telling. And that too, without any scientific evidence. And the next thing is that the law of minimum dosage, etc. In that debate they were telling. That already I had told you. Regarding the immunity, it enhances, ultra dilutions enhances the immunity level. So it becomes the answer for that. The least essential is needed. If you go with the nanopharmacology, you can understand. Least amount is only necessary for the stimulations. I'm not telling. The latest science tells. When the science advances automatically, this will also get advanced. And the homeopathy will also get totally established. Right now, up to 30 C's, it has been identified that material content is there. Up to 30 C, it is identified. Further, there is no such an amount, high amount of micros or something like that is to identify is there. So, when the science advances, automatically homeopathy will also get established further. Now also homeopathy is totally established scientifically and clinically. And right now, all the studies, thousands of papers are there. Thousands of papers are getting published. The only thing is that many times, control papers are very less. Why? Because we cannot take a risk in with the patient. That's why control studies are less in number. So, please, before criticizing homeopathy, please do read Organ of Medicine and the various good literatures like Materia Medica Pura by Samuel Hahnemann, Herring Guiding Symptoms, Boric Materia Medica. Please do read these ones. What it is telling. After reading that, you will understand whether it treats the disease, whether all the disease comes in that or not. So this is a small advent from me to give you a small explanation regarding. I don't want to criticize any system of medicine. Basically, all systems are having scope and limitations. Like that homeopathy is having also having scope, some limitations also. With this, I conclude this. Thank you.